I've gone over to the rack and I've pulled out all the components that we're going to need in order to put together a Colpitts oscillator. Unlike the Wainbridge oscillator that we put together in one of the previous videos, the Colpitts oscillator today is going to operate at 1 MHz, which is in the radio frequency band. Op amps typically don't have a very good response at such high frequencies. So in order to build the Colpitts oscillator today, we're going to have to use a transistor amplifier. Because there are a lot of connections in the Colpitts oscillator, if we use a transistor amplifier, I think it's a better idea to just put together the amplifier portion of the circuit first. That's a circuit that I've gone ahead and built right here. In order to check the gain, we're going to have to hook it up to the DC power supply, run a signal into the base of the transistor, and then check to see with the oscillator what the gain of that signal is. I've set our DC power supply to 9 volts. I'm going to go ahead and turn it on. All we've done at this point is bias the transistor. I'd now like to turn on the function generator because we plan to design a Colpitts oscillator operating at 1 MHz. Let's test our amplifier at the same frequency. So I'm going to change the frequency here to 1 MHz, or as close to it as I can get. And let's make it a sine wave. I'm going to use channel 1 of the oscilloscope to monitor the input, and I'm going to use channel 2 in order to monitor the output. Our function generator is giving us a peak-to-peak voltage of approximately 1 volt. And at the output side of our transistor, we can see a peak-to-peak voltage of about 900 millivolts. That means that our gain in this particular circuit is around 0.9. You can also notice that these two signals are out of phase with one another. That's an indication that the common emitter configuration of the transistor is an inverting amplifier. This gain is not going to be enough in order to get our Colpitts oscillator to work. I'm going to insert this 10 microfarad capacitor in parallel with the emitter resistor. Let's go ahead and do that and see how that affects the gain. As we can see, the gain has increased substantially. We now have more than 6 volts peak-to-peak at the output. Unfortunately, the transistor circuit is now saturated, so we don't have a very beautiful sine wave anymore. In order to lower down the gain just a little bit and clean up the output, I'm going to take this 1 kilo-ohm resistor and put it in series with the capacitor that we just added to the circuit. Let's see what that does to the gain. So after adding that resistor to the circuit, we now recover a very beautiful sine wave at the output. And our gain is approximately 1.6. That's probably good enough to make the Colpitts oscillator as a whole work. So I'm going to disconnect the function generator from the circuit and put together the feedback network. We no longer need both channels of the oscilloscope. Let's just use channel 1 in order to monitor the output. As we can see, we have a very beautiful sine wave with a frequency of approximately 1.09 MHz. And an amplitude of 3.56 volts. We should be able to hear this in the radio. Let's give it a try. I have an AM radio right here. I'm going to hold it near our circuit and change the frequency. Let's see what happens when we get near our radio station's frequency. As we approach 1.1 megahertz, we hear silence from the radio. That's because our constant amplitude emission is being interpreted by the radio as a silent broadcast. Let's turn it off. And we now hear noise from the radio. Let me turn it on again. Let's check the range. So we don't have very good range, We can improve that a little bit with an antenna. Let's give it a try. I'm standing 2 meters away from the circuit and the radio is still able to detect the broadcast. If we were to properly handle impedance matching with the antenna, we would be able to transmit a bit further. In the next videos, we'll go ahead and proceed to modulate the carrier wave and create a real radio broadcast.